Hello healers, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. Today we have another unbox flip through, and it's for this beautiful deck here, the Sacred Self-Care Oracle, okay, from Jill Pyle. And this is a lovely deck with 55 cards and a guidebook, and I love when the deck has so many cards like that. There's so many options for you to connect, and this is a lovely color, okay. You can see here all this true purple, many lilac colors in this deck, and this is Hay House sturdy box like we are used with Hay House. You can see opens on the side, lovely colors. You can see here rainbows, stars, and you can see here's just the purple and pinks. You can see here more colorful inside, a lovely box definitely. And you can see here, take care of yourself so you can shine your soul's light. Beautiful, lovely box, definitely nice. And again, 55 cards, I like that. It comes with the guidebook, you can see here. And all the information here with the numbers, where to find them, that's nice. The content, welcome, some spread ideas, and a full page for each card, and you can see here, in black and white. Lovely. We're gonna go through the cards, and like always I will flip through and get a card of the day and read the full message from the guidebook, so you have an idea how the guidebook is. But you can see here guys how lovely, okay, this is completely matte. This is such a lovely color. This backs are really really nice, okay, true lilac. And you can see here really lovely with the colors of the box, so beautiful. True bigger size, normally bigger size Oracle card. Let me compare here, like always, comparing with the Light Seer, which is a standard tarot size. So just to have an idea, normally a bit bigger, like Oracle cards are. There's no standard really, but normally Oracle cards are a bit bigger. Again, love the backs, and we're gonna go through the cards. Okay, they have numbers here and a couple of keywords, but so colorful. This fun artwork as well. I really, really like this. And again, guys, I'm going to go through, flip through at the end and read from the guidebook, so you have an idea what the guidebook has to offer. But lovely here. So you can see here, the first one is abundance planning. And you can see here, like, making goals, ideas. You can see here, as well, lovely. I really like this artwork, okay? Very fun as well. A long time. Aromatherapy. They are thick enough, okay, guys? You can see here. Okay, very good quality. Okay, good quality for sure. Aromatherapy. So there are many ways in this deck for you to like find that there are like practical things you can do, okay, for self-care. So this is a very interesting deck. Be Still, Beauty Ritual, and Build Strength, Burning Bowl Ritual, Chanting, Clean Your Space, practical things, really, really straightforward. Clear Your Energy Field, Connect with Crystals, love that. Connect with Fire, Connect with Earth, straightforward ideas here for you. Connect with Ancestors, Connect with Womb. Interesting. Make an altar. Create art. Dance. Deep breathing. Dream journal. Nice. Drink tea. Lovely colors. You can see here so many pink and purples. Energy work. Family. Like water, lovely colors. Ground yourself. Health checkup. Hydrate. Should leave this one all the time around here. We all need it. Intuition. Journal. Look for fairies. Nice. Look for the stars. Make a meal. Make a vision board. massage, meditate, movement, music, nourish your temple, plan a vacation, pleasure, positive affirmation, see how thick they are, they're like good quality, they're not getting stuck together or anything, read, rest, sex, sing, soak in a bath, sound healing, spend time with animals, spend time with friends, sweet treat, sync with the moon, take a walk, use your hands, watch a movie, and the last one, write a gratitude list. Lovely, guys, I really like these cards. You can see how colorful, beautiful colors, beautiful, straightforward messages here. So much you can get from them. Lovely. Let me just go through a quick flip through here. Let me make sure we find something here for us. So just make sure we shuffle here, find something for us. Definitely a good quality, guys. It's just completely matte, so it's very easy to shuffle. Okay, this is falling, so I take it. And it's saying here, chanting. Okay, let me find on the guidebook here. And you can see it has numbers. So this is number 8, which is one of my favorite numbers. And okay, chanting. You can see here about it. So it's showing here the chakras as well, okay, with this chanting, which is lovely. You can see the different things you can chant depending on the chakras. That is nice. Okay, so if you're new to chanting, you can start with learning to tone OM, okay, OM, and the sound of each chakra. At first, practice chanting on your own to gain a level of comfort. And this is all of them here, okay? For the crown chakra, OM, third eye chakra, OM, throat chakra, HAM, heart chakra, YAM, solar plexus chakra, RAM, sacral chakra, VAM, root chakra, LAM. Okay, experiment with the different tones, noticing which ones come easily or feel challenging. Free yourself from worrying about how you sound. Allow your unique voice to resonate and express itself. When you are ready to deeper and express the sensation of changing in a group, look for local singing, chanting, or kirtan events. Most yoga studios will include chanting as part of the practice, typically at the beginning of or the end of the class. You can also pioneer the effort within your community and gather some loved ones who are willing to chant with you. This activity is especially fun to try in an enclosed space that has a loud echo or outside surrounding by beautiful nature. Journal prompt. What block, real or imagined, prevent you from chanting? What practical steps can you take to eliminate those blocks? Very interesting. Okay, guys, you can see here how practical it is. And I feel like this gives some ideas of what you can do as well. I feel like this is interesting to try, okay? If you wanted to try chanting, you know, if you want to go back and pause the video on the sounds that you can use for the different chakras, okay? Just to see if you have an issue or, you know, stuck or with any of them, that maybe a chakra that you wanted to work on, okay? This is a very practical, like I said, deck. And I feel like those are many ideas that you can get here, like a card of the day, what you wanted to do that day, or focus that day, or that week, or anything that it can help you out. And I definitely will use this on my picker cards and live videos of things that you can do to help you out with any specific situation. So I feel like this is very practical. And like I said, beautiful colors, lovely, all this pastel pink purple colors, they are really nice, and the quality, like the artwork, is very fun as well. So there's not anything hard here, so I feel like this has a good vibration as well. And I'll make sure to leave all the links below if you want to have them for yourself. I feel like 55 cards, they're definitely something good here, you know, for you. You can always connect with at least some of them, if not all of them. So 55 cards, I like when the decks have so many cards like that, so it's always a chance to connect. And like I said, guys, you'll see more of them in my channel anyway. And like always, let me know if you like this video, if it helps you out in any way. And as always, I wish you a lovely, blessed, and healing day. Thanks for watching.